Hey, it's World. I am back with another video. Today, I'm going to be sharing 5 different bags that I plan on using or predicting I will be using the most in the next month or this particular season or so. I was tagged by the awesome Jessie Styles to do this video, and I'm sure you've seen her video already. But if you haven't, definitely check her video and channel out, as she releases almost on a daily basis and she has the most interesting topics. She and I feel like we vibe in a very different way, where her mind is literally thinking about purses every day, and also me thinking about purses every day and scrolling the interwebs as we're doing our 9-to-5 job, so to speak, or 8-to-5, whatever you call it. I'm always out on the hunt of finding deals, looking at indie brands, and just like, don't ask me how my mind works. It's just thinking about purses all day. I've got issues. I know I have issues. The original tag was started by JoJo Lux, and I'm glad that Jessie had introduced me to her channel, because YouTube is like a rabbit hole. You can find a lot of things and you find a lot of people's channels. Some of them, you know, might bore you. Some of them is incredibly interesting, right? So I'm glad she was able to introduce JoJo Lux to me. So I'm ripping through her videos as well. So I'm just gonna go right into it. So these are the four of them are in front of me. I'm back in Chicago for a couple weeks here. The other two that I'll just kind of talk about first is going to be my MZ Wallace little hot pink tote bag. I did a whole entire video, and the giveaway is still available for another week or so. So if you want to enter the giveaway, the criterias are going to be listed there, and I do a more in-depth review on those two particular bags. And then I also have my Dress Up Your Purse white bag. Those are going to be my hot girl summer bags, so to speak. So I'm really excited to be using that. So those are the top two. Are the first, I'm going to lump them. I'm cheating a little, okay? But I'm going to be lumping that as my first bag that I will be using in the next month or two for this season or so. I also want to include this one. I won't talk too much about this just because I did a whole entire unboxing video, how I was able to get this at like $900 off during a Nordstrom sale. This is a new bag, and it is, I want to say, my first lunar bag, or like the crescent shape. So I'm pretty excited to be using this. I used this on my most recent New York trip. Still got my bunch of stuff in there. I will say this one definitely does not fit a lot, so you're going to have to pare down to your essentials. And the opening is fine, but if you fill it up all the way to the top, and if you were to put something over it, like it might block the magnet, so it might be a little bit hard to close, or it just has a little bit of a gap open. So something to keep in mind if you are interested in this bag. But overall, it stays on my shoulder very nicely. It doesn't slip off or anything. Pretty happy with my first use of this bag, but I will give you an update as I use this bag a little bit more in the next month or two. So this is my first bag, and of course I'll link the videos I just talked about down below for you if you want to check that out. The next bag I want to cover is going to be my Fendi baguette that I got in Greece last year. I have been abandoning this bag a little bit, and I feel like I definitely need to use this one a little bit more. It is a little bit more of a flashy, with all of the monogram, is that Fendigram? Is that what you call it? I don't know. But I haven't used this bag a while, so I feel like I do need to incorporate this in my daily routine. As you know, I am a very high-low dresser. I tend to dress really cheaply. Like, I'm happy to shop something from H&M or perhaps Zara. I have a bunch of clothes from like Aerie, just very basic stuff. So for me, I do like a little pizzazz with my purses so I can show it off. And I think this is a very low key, but you know, with all of the logos on there, but it's not like hot pink or anything. It's very in your face. And if you don't know Fendi very well, then of course you don't know what this bag is. I love this bag because it does come with a nice thick strap, which you cannot crossbody. You can definitely shoulder with it. I did talk about how there are two D rings when it comes to this bag. Completely appreciate that. The attention to detail. And of course, during the summer, I don't plan on carrying a lot, but I did show you what fits in this bag. So you can still, it's not a tote bag, so you can still fit a plenty in here. If I'm going to be going out for an entire day, this is definitely going to be a good one to use. I don't have a lot of fabric bags, and it's funny how I have two, not two recent, the most recent purchases, and they're both fabric. So I'm wondering how this is gonna look after using it a number of times and the wear and tear. Is it gonna ball up? Is it, so I'll let you know. Or if you have one, let me know how the wear and tear it works on these canvas or fabric bags. So this is going to be number two, or number three, I guess. And before I show you bag number four, to Jesse's point, I have so many freaking bags that I sometimes forget how many bags I have. And you know what, honestly, I'm scared to count how many bags I have. Jesse mentioned that she has 22 bags. I was just like, totally have way more than that. She is strictly Hermes. I completely appreciate that. And she did mention that you could totally go down a rabbit hole and start purchasing way too many bags that you'll never use if she doesn't just focus on Hermes. I like variety. So I'm not the type of person, that's the difference between she and I, is that she's okay having, you know, not just her, like anybody who's like an Hermes collector, there's only so many different styles, and you want, you know, a 25, a 30, a 35, and a 40, different sizes in Birkins, and then you've got the different leathers. There's infinite amount of combinations with the gold hardware, with the silver hardware, whatever it is. I'm not the kind of person where I want, you know, I like a bag, and then I want it in every size, and then I want it in six different colors. That's just not me. I feel like there's a lot of different styles that are being released all the time. I like variety in my collection. Completely different from how I dress. If I have like a black dress that I like, I'm gonna buy like three of them just in case they go out of stock because I really like it. Or perhaps there's a pair of sneakers that's white. I just recently bought like four pairs of white leather sneakers. Do I really need four pairs of white sneakers that look very similar? Absolutely not. So we all have different fashion choices. So I appreciate, you know, her sharing that, and that's very different from me, and it just gives me perspective, right? All right, I'm gonna stop yapping here. Let's talk the fourth bag. So I did not do an unboxing for this. I recently purchased this from the Japanese vintage market. I think I might have overpaid a little for this. I didn't do an unboxing, but I will be doing a review on this particular bag because it's just gorgeous. I really love beige bags. I have an obsession with them as of right now, right? Some people out there have an obsession with black bags. I happen to be in love with beige bags. So when this came about and I saw it was caviar skin and it's beige and it's gold hardware and it's got the big CC logo, it just hit the spot. I had to get it. And this one has been really nice. There's a little bit of wear here. So there's a little bit of wear here. Obviously, you can't really see it when you're far, but if you're looking at it closely, it is going to show the age of it. And this one's from, I want to say again, the early 1994, 1995, but I freaking love this bag. I've used it a number of times already, and it's just a single flat bag. And, oh, sorry, I know I said caviar. It's actually grained, so there's a difference. The caviar has bigger, I guess, what do you call these, scales. It's much thicker or bigger in size, whereas when you talk about the grained leather, the grained, I think that's what they call it, the little scales that you see here is going to be smaller. And from what I understood, I asked around about it, they said that this is going to be a little bit softer than the caviar version of it. So fun facts, right? I didn't know that. I learned something new. I also got this one. It was a little bit tarnished right here. I wouldn't say tarnished. It was a little bit more of a little black discoloration, I guess, here from like this part closing the twist lock here. I can't find my words today. So I did buy like a gold polishing cloth, and this just made it extremely shiny. So definitely, if you have the 24 karat gold that you bought vintage and it's looking a little bit, you know, tarnished or a little bit dull looking, definitely get the gold polishing cloth. It works wonders. So I will link that down. I got it from Amazon for like $10. So it's completely worth it, and you can reuse it many, many times over. So the inside of it, you can see it's an open compartment. Obviously you can fit a lot of stuff, and there's a little zipper compartment. It didn't come with a card. It did come with a seal. So you can definitely put some stuff in here if you like. It's a very structured bag, and the strap itself is going to be only long enough for you to do a shoulder carry. It will not be long enough for a crossbody. I do wish it had the two rivets. I know the reissue has the two rivets. This one, not that I would carry this as a clutch. I feel like it might be too long for a clutch, but you do have to like make the effort of pulling it all in just to tuck it in here. And the strap here, the leather strap here, does not sit flush to it. I foresee myself using this particular bag quite often this summer, just because I love the Chanel large gold CC, and it's the 24 karat gold. It goes with any outfit that you're wearing, whether you're going black or you're going a little bit more colorful. This is just a really nice beigey color that will pair with any style that you wanted to go for. If you want to go fancy, if you want to go casual, this is going to be an awesome one for you to look at. I also really like this one just because it's in the square shape instead of the traditional rectangular shape, where the maxi or the jumbo that you see, that is the single flap. I feel like this is definitely a little bit more unique. All right, let's go to the Hermes. So I never did an unboxing. Let me know if you want me to do a full-blown review on this and how I got this bag and what I got it for, the weight of it. I know there's a lot of reviews on this particular bag already. So just let me know. I don't want to do something that's been done like 50 times already. But this is a bag I got last year. Last summer in particular, when I visited Stockholm. And it's going to be the Picotin 18. Sorry. The Picotin 18 in the trench color. It's such an adorable bag. I've only used it once. So I feel like let's not like neglect our bags, because they all need to breathe and be used, come out to the world and be shared with the world. It comes with a lock and key. Obviously, I'm not gonna go through in that much detail, but it's such a gorgeous bag that I haven't used. I also got an insert for it. I think I just got it from Amazon. So it comes so that it keeps its structure, right? Right now, the structure is really nice because I've only used it once. And I'm just like, my precious, you cannot be scuffed up or anything, right? It's an Hermes. And it's my first Hermes bag that I got in the Hermes boutique. So I'm just like, oh, I don't want it to get scuffed up or anything. But really, honestly, like I need to start using this bag. But I got this insert for it. It's pretty cute, fits really nicely. Comes with a little zipper. I'll link it down below for you if you want to get this for your Picotin. But nothing crazy to talk about. I will tell you a story. Again, let me know down in the comments below if you want me to tell you a story on how I got this bag, where I got it, how much I got it for, and of course I got a deal on it. Can you expect anything less from me? But look at this. Isn't it adorable? With the little feet at the bottom. So yeah, these are the five bags, well, really six bags, that I think that I will be using very often in the next month or so, or just the summer season in general. I hope you enjoyed it, looked at a little bit of eye candy. Hit and like that subscribe button if you haven't done so. And of course, like I said, check out Jesse's video, check out JoJo Lux's channel. Let us grow our community and share the love of purses together. Check out my friend's fake collection here. and whatever the YouTube algorithm thinks that you will like here. Life is hard. I want to help you save time and money so that you can somehow adult easier and hopefully less than retail. I'll see you next time.